been saving people money for 85 years. It's hard to beat that.
But you're right.
Switch to Geico. It's obviously a good idea.
There's something for everyone on Discovery Plus. The streaming home of ghostly freakouts, muscle car spinouts, and 90-day makeouts.
I'm really in love with her.
Start your free trial today for exclusive originals and a huge collection of favorites.
Whoa!
Then dive into nature docs, geek out with the family,
boom,
and get your grub on.
I could eat this every day.
The streaming home of true crime, paranormal, food, home, nature, romance, plus so much more. Discovery Plus.
Goosebumps hearing the Olympic music, ladies? Does it give you goosebumps? Because it gives me goosebumps, and I'm not even in the Olympics. Though, I won the sack race, sixth grade elementary school, Adams School for track and field day. Sack race. Potato sack.
Yeah.
And when I went to junior high and tried up for the track team, they said, what event are you in for? And I said, I'm a sack racer.
And
And you know what they said? The coach said, we don't do the sack race in school. So had they done the sack race, I think I could have qualified for the Olympics. I won the blue ribbon in sixth grade, first place.
You should have switched to the three-legged race.
Do they do that in the Olympics?
They could.
Yeah. It's the Peterson sisters, Tabitha and Tara. Can I call you Tab?
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, because I think we got a good vibe already. and then we've met before at the Breath of Hope Lung Foundation charity event. Mm-hmm. And we've always had fun there. And you're both really good golfers from what I understand, too.
We're not half bad.
Yeah, not half bad. As a matter of fact, I think I was told that Tara won the Women's Club Championship doubles match play and the Mr. and Mrs. Championship at the North Oaks Golf Club.
I did.
You've won them all.
I've won them all.
Are there other people there that wish you would leave the North Oaks Golf Club so they would have a chance to win? Do you ever feel guilty about continuing to just win every event?
Well, no.
No, you don't mind winning every event, do you?
It's fun.
What's the Olympics? That's pretty cool. When did this all come up? The qualifiers? Tell me what happened. Where was the qualifier? When was it? How did it go? And then the culmination was obviously qualifying. How did that all work?
So we spent probably 12 days or so in Omaha, Nebraska, in the middle of November. And that was the Olympic trials.
That would be the only reason you would be in Omaha in the middle of November would be for the Olympic trials, right?
Yeah. Yes.
So we had basically two games a day, but towards the end it was one game a day. We played a double round robin. There were six teams, so we played 10 games total in the double round robin. And then it was a best of three. The top two teams played a best of three final series. But we ended up winning the first two, so we didn't have to play the third game.
And you're from the St. Paul Curling Club.
Mm-hmm.
Where were the others from all over the country? I mean, I got to think there's not a curling club in Tampa Bay. Tampa Bay, is there? Or do they have them in the southern parts of the world?
We've curled in Jacksonville, Florida.
You really have?
We have, yeah. And we've also curled at the Coyotes Curling Club in Phoenix.
The Coyotes Curling Club, mm-hmm. Or is it the Coyotes Curling Club?
Great question. Yeah. I don't actually know.
I didn't think you would.
Yeah.
Those are the things I think about, but that's the way my mind works.
Fair enough.
So there were teams from all over. Was there, you only had to play the two games to win, so you kind of, it was kind of a yawner, apparently, getting in, qualifying for the Olympics in the last matches, or you call them games, right?
Either way.
Either way. So the last one, was it competitive or did you just blow them out? It sounds like you destroyed them.
The first game of the series was definitely a tight game. It came down to the last shot. But the second one, they conceded in eight ends. So we definitely controlled the whole game.
No kidding.
Yeah.
Was there any moment during any of your matches where it looked like it was about to get away from you and you were in trouble? Did you have to rally and make a great comeback or anything?
Well, we did lose one game in the round robin portion. So
one game is all.
Yep. So that one, definitely we had some moments where we were like, gosh, if we could just get it together a little bit better. Mm-hmm. But we tried. Like I did have a very difficult shot for the win, and I just missed it. So we ended up losing that one. But yeah, I mean, curling and any sport, right, it's you just never know. If you could have a very on day, or you could just be slightly off. And it's a team sport too, so there's a lot of different components with every player. So
Team Peterson consists of Tab. You're the skip. Nina Roth is the vice skip. Becca Hamilton is second, and Terry, you're the lead. And again, maybe a lot of our listeners, Team Schuster, mm-hmm. you're very familiar with them, of course. They won the gold mm-hmm. medal for the men's in the last Olympics. They're favorites of the Power Trip morning show. So they've been on. So I think a lot of people understand curling. I'm very novice. I don't know if I've ever watched a curling match other than a highlight here or there, but I've never like sat in my chair and said, I'm going to watch curling.
Well, so, now you will.
Well, now I'm more. Because I hope you don't mind. There's no financial compensation for being the official curling team of the Common Man program. I've just said that's what you are. You're not going to get anything for it, at least. Though I did promise that if you win the gold medal, Tenneby and I, the senior interim producer of the program, he's just the interim producer of the show. He's been here for 13 or 14 years. I don't know if he's cut out for it. We'll take you guys out to...
I heard Chili's.
Chili's.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Well, because Team Schuster got taken out to
Manny's.
To Manny's, mm-hmm. but...
Yeah, I would prefer Applebee's, if you don't mind.
No, we'll do Applebee's. We'll do Applebee's, because I don't got morning show money. I can't afford to go to Manny's.
Makes sense.
So we would take you out to
I want to know about in the qualifying, because I would have to imagine you're familiar with a lot of the teams there, that you've maybe interacted with them or played against them. Like, is that accurate? And how, like, going into this, did you think, hey, we have a legit shot of winning this whole thing, going to the Olympics? I mean, what were the expectations going into it, and what did you know about your competition?
Yeah, that's a great question. We were very confident as long as we played our best, we would win and go to the Olympics. And we played well, and so we did.
Yeah, I mean, going into the event, we, like this year, I think we're ranked maybe 9, it kind of switches, but 7, 8, or 9 on the world rankings. And so we're definitely, of all the United States women's teams, we're the highest ranked team. So we had that advantage going into it as well.
As I mentioned, I'm a novice to all this. I don't understand. What's a skip? What's a vice skip? What's a second? And what's the lead? What do you do? Which one does the broom? That's the only thing I know, is somebody sweeps.
That's me. Mm-hmm.
You're the sweeper.
Yep.
I don't sweep. I stand there.
Did you know right away that you were a really good sweeper and you loved it as soon as you picked up the broom?
No, it's a lot of work.
Is it really?
It looks like a lot of work.
It is. It's a good workout.
So then did you draw the short straw then? Do they
Pretty
say,
much,
well, we have
yeah.
to have a sweeper and yeah. it's going to be you?
Yep.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
Is there like internal debate? Like you get like bands all the time where they all think they should be the ones writing the song and they should be the lead singers. Like do you have that component within a curling team where you think you should be the skip?
No, I don't want to be the skip. That's too much pressure.
What is
Tab
this?
Can have that all to herself.
Well, what are the responsibilities of the skip? What do you do?
Well, besides stand there and yell, I'm at the other end of the ice, calling the game, calling the shots, giving the broom, and reading the line and telling the sweepers when to sweep or not. There's lots of communication involved in terms of what the speed of the rock is. The sweepers communicate that down to me and everything. But yeah, the skip generally throws the last two stones. So you're throwing the shot for the win or for the loss.
So she gets all the glory with the win, but also... if it doesn't go the best, well, it's her fault.
It's my fault.
Not mine. And then I swept it as best as I could.
Yeah, you did what you could. What's the vice skip do?
Go ahead.
Yeah, they go in order. So the lead, so I will throw the first two stones.
Okay.
And then the second will throw the second two stones. Uh-huh. And then while the second is throwing, then I'm sweeping with the third or the vice. So then the second will throw. Go ahead.
Everybody takes a turn sweeping then.
Except for Tab. She's the laziest.
Right. Though I get that, then that would be perfect for me because I'm lazy. I'm both lazy.
Yeah. Stupid. Yeah. Okay. But are you smart?
Yeah. No, I'm stupid.
Okay. Well, then maybe curling's not for you.
Well, I got to admit, can I say this? And you've probably heard this before. It looks kind of silly.
Oh, yes.
I mean, it really does.
It's
I look
a very
at it
silly
and I go,
sport.
And I even say, you know, people will say this about golf, my favorite sport. They'll say, oh, it's not really a sport. It's an activity. You're not an athlete. Do you ever get that or hear that? It's like, to me, this seems like it's something you could do while you're having a beer, you know, and I'm not trying to rip you. I'm just saying it looks like one of those things. What goes into being a good curler? I mean,
I mean, the sport has many layers of skill level, I should say. Like we play Tuesday night league. It's a very social sport. You know, generally
pre-COVID,
you go up and have a beer after the game with your
the winners by the losers the first round.
You don't drink during though.
No,
you can.
Okay. Oh, you can though.
I mean,
you just have to leave it on the other side of the glass. You can't have it out on the ice because you don't want to spill it on the ice. But yeah, you can drink during.
Depends on what tournament you're playing in. Maybe you're drinking.
Are you better at curling when you've had a couple, or are you better when you're when your mind
Yeah, probably not. Probably not. No,
it's not the safest thing to do because you know you might want to wear a helmet just in case you fall.
Is it dangerous?
If you get alcohol involved,
Does anybody ever get injured while participating? Mm-hmm. Like they have an injury report, like, you know, tabs out with a stubbed toe, or what kind of injuries will happen in curling?
Yeah. I mean, anything's possible. One of the really good Canadian players, he actually just qualified his team to the Beijing Olympics too, Brad Gushue. A few years ago, he tripped over a rock and he fell and hit his eye and it like broke open. It was bleeding and he had to leave and go to the.
Yeah, he had to leave to go to the ER in the middle of the game. You should look up that video. Actually, it's really gruesome.
Was he drinking? It sounds like he.
No, he wasn't. Okay. I'm pretty sure he was sober, but it can be dangerous.
Let me do this. I have to take a break, but I've got other things I want to ask you. Intend to be, you know, I'm not a great interviewer. I just, whatever pops into my head, but I want to know how you first got into it, got started, and why you did it, and how excited you are, and we'll get to all of that. So let's take a short break. We'll come back. We have Team Peterson out of the St. Paul Curling Club. They've played out of there since 2000, and they are headed to Beijing for the Winter Olympics. They're the official curling team of the Common Man program. Right now, another sport that takes place on ice. The Wild is the subject of Wild Today with Tenneby. Tenneby.
Yeah, Wild Today is brought to you by Carboni's Pizza. Pizza the whole family loves since 1954. The Wild host the New Jersey Devils tonight at Xcel Energy Center. The Wild won in New Jersey 8 days ago in a shootout after blowing a 2-0 lead. The Devils are coming off a 5-2 loss to the San Jose Sharks. Wild, they've won 4 in a row, and they get Matt Zuccarello back tonight. He missed the last 2 games after taking a slash to the hand, but he'll be in the lineup. Jared Spurgeon, he's still out with a lower body injury. And Frederick Goudreau is still in COVID protocols. By the way, Kaapo Kähkönen will get his second consecutive start in goal tonight. Wild Devils tonight at 7. Wild Fan Line with myself and Pat Micheletti will follow tonight right here on The Fan. That was Wild Today, brought to you by Carboni's Pizza. Order yours tonight at carbonis.com.
The Common Man.
Man, sometimes you are so negative on subjects, you're ruined radio, man.
Weekdays at noon on The Fan.
You went online to switch your car insurance to Progressive so you could save money.
Minnesota's Christmas station, powered by UCARE, people-powered health plans.
Clam Outdoors has something for every ice angler. From portable ice shelters, ice armor by Clam Suits and Gear, Clam Pro Tackle, rods, reels, and combos, and so much more. Check out the full line of ice fishing gear at clamoutdoors.com. Pursue the ice.
Hey, it's 10 to be here. Tara and Tabitha both mentioned that while you're curling, you can have a drink. I'm sure you could also eat some Carboni's pizza while you're doing it, and wherever your curling club is, they've probably got a Carboni's near you because there's 3 locations in the Twin Cities. There's 5 in Western Wisconsin, 1 coming to Rochester soon. If you want to cater at your curling club, you can do it because Carboni's caters. No matter how big or small your event, make sure Carboni's is on your guest list. They have pizza, hoagies, salads, pasta, and more. It's a restaurant your entire family will love. Order yours tonight at carbonis.com.
You can get a stunning 2-carat Eco-4 lab-grown diamond set in a classic solitaire mounting at wedding day for just $5,995. A 2-carat solitaire for just $5,995, only at wedding day diamonds.
Festivals, football, the great outdoors. Some people say fall is the best time of the year. It may also be a great time to consider getting vaccinated against COVID-19. sponsored by BioNTech and Pfizer.
Come in here, make any occasion a delicious meal with a Casey's Share Pack. The Casey's Share Pack features a large, single-topping, fresh-baked pizza using made-from-scratch dough, Casey's Cheesy Breadsticks, and the new delicious Party Brookie dessert that's made to share for only $19.99. The Casey's Share Pack is perfect for any holiday event. Get the Casey's Share Pack curbside, pickup, or delivery through the Casey's app for only $19.99. Order the Casey's Share Pack in the app and celebrate with your favorite group. Casey's, here for good.
When the kids turn unholy, Harrelson's Own keeps my patience divine.
Life can be chaotic, but Harrelson's Own CBD helps keep you calm through any storm. We make every bottle of Harrelson's Own from 100% organic CBD, hand-harvested right from the farm. Our nano-emulsified technology makes it so your body absorbs it immediately, so you start to feel it in seconds, not 60 minutes. It's actually one of the fastest-acting CBDs on the market today. Some people take it for general well-being. For me, it just makes everything about my day a little better.
It helps me relax. It helps me be there with my kids. Give your life a boost.
So to sum it all up, you're going to feel the benefits quickly, love the way it feels, pay a fair price, and you're going to thank us for it. Give Harrelson's Own a try, from our family to yours. Go to HarrelsonCBD.com to order yours now. HarrelsonCBD.com. 5G is...
This holiday season to get more for your dough on stand mixers or get more for your buck on this season's hottest tech and gaming gear. And on eBay, you can even get more Cyber Monday rewind the clock deals. Cyber Monday prices are back for one day only. Get more and save more on premium brands with eBay's can't miss Monday deals. Get more when you get it on eBay.
Great savings and premium products professionally installed. Go to buildersandremodelers.com.
This report is sponsored by Papa Murphy's.
Fan forecast.
Slight chance of snow tonight. Overnight low of 33, 42, and sunny tomorrow.
At Papa Murphy's, we make fresh pizza that you bake at home.
Go, Dad.
Because at home,
here we go.
Pizza means game on.
Yes!
Right now, get the chicken garlic pizza for just $12.
Rematch?
Papa Murphy's. Change the way you pizza.
Back to Dan Cole, the Common Man, from the 651 Carpet Studios on iHeartRadio and FM 100.3 KFAN.
YouTube channel again, Tenneby? You say they can watch this.
Oh, yeah, just KFN YouTube channel or any of our social media channels. You can watch this.
This controversial interview. It's not like 60 Minutes or anything. It's with the Peterson sisters, Tabitha and Tara. I call her Tab because we got a good vibe out of the St. Paul Curling Club since 2000. You grew up.
That one's Tara, isn't it?
You.
I think you just pointed it. Yeah.
Well, I wasn't actually pointing.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No.
With your eyes.
Tab and I have got a great vibe. I know who's who. We go way back to the Breath of Hope Lung Foundation tournament. They grew up in Eagan. I know everything about them. They both have advanced degrees at the University of Minnesota. You have real jobs, you know, like professional athletes, baseball players, football players, basketball, hockey. They don't have other jobs. It's like, no, this is what we do. We have an off season.
Correct.
One of you is a dentist and one of you is a pharmacist.
Yes.
Why did you choose those lines of work? Did looking in people's mouths and fixing teeth always interest you? Or
always? Well, actually, this is our favorite line. Our parents brainwashed us into healthcare.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. My dad's a dentist, mom's a hygienist, so that's where the dentistry came from. And they also said, you know, go into healthcare, any job in healthcare, be a doctor, you'll always have a job.
I just was at the dentist Monday and got my teeth whitened.
Oh, they look beautiful.
Aren't they beautiful pearly
yeah.
whites? Thank
Amazing
you very much.
Amazing job.
I appreciate that. Thank
yeah.
you.
You're welcome.
And then you're a pharmacist. You dole out drugs.
I do. I count by fives. And...
You count by fives. Yeah. Anytime I've had to get a prescription, they always say, would you like to talk to the pharmacist? And then you come over and you explain to me exactly,
yep.
here's the side effects. Here's how much you should take. Be careful with it, right?
Yep. Yep.
And where's your dental practice?
I work in White Bear Lake. It's a private practice called Isaacson Gentle Dentistry.
Ah, Gentle Dentistry.
Yes, we're very gentle.
Yes. And then you're a pharmacist. Where, can I ask?
Mm-hmm. I work at Hennepin Healthcare and casually at CVS and Target.
Do you get any sponsorships for paid sponsorships for curling? Do you have any money coming in that way? That's legal now, right? I know for the used to be. Oh no, Olympics used to be all amateur. You couldn't have, and now they've got NBA players playing on the dream team in the NBA. Do you get sponsorships like that, if I can ask?
We can.
And you'll take them.
We don't have many.
Do you want to help us find some?
You know, I can absolutely do that. I've got a couple 13, 14 clients of my own. Maybe we can steer them your
direction.
Sounds
like we should start at Applebee's.
Yeah, let's
do an Applebee's endorsement.
We could do an Applebee's endorsement. If a closed circuit to any advertisers out there, if you'd like to jump on the old curling bandwagon of the St. Paul Curling
we'll
Club and Gene
you.
Peterson, they will... take you. So how did you get introduced to curling? We were talking off break. When I was a kid, even though curling existed, I knew nothing about it. How did you find out about it? How did you get introduced to it?
So actually our grandpa is from Canada and he used to play the game. So we knew of the sport, but we didn't actually try it till we were about 10. My mom had a friend that was playing in league at the St. Paul Curling Club and she said, you should bring the family down and try this. And so we all tried it together. Mom, dad, Tara, me, and our brother, Trent. So we tried it, and then didn't fall in love with it by any means, but our parents got us registered in the Saturday morning, junior curling, 9 in the morning. So in high school, we were definitely not a big fan of that, but we kept going, and then made friends along the way, and you join a team, and then you start to go to Bonspiels throughout the state and go over to Wisconsin maybe and do a junior Bonspiel. So yeah, we got hooked eventually.
Well, when did you start taking it seriously? Was it when you just, as long as we're doing it, we may as well? Or was it, you know, we're actually pretty good at this. When did you know this was something you could excel at?
After high school?
Yeah, I was going to say maybe 17, 18-ish. Mm-hmm. Yeah. You kind of get, you know, like I said, we formed a team and then... actually, our team at the time, her dad was very much like, this team has potential, you know. So then we registered for the Minnesota State Playdowns and made our first trip to the Junior Nationals in 2006, I want to say. So he's the one that kind of noticed her, Alex Carlson, her dad, was the one that was like, these girls are good and this is a good team. So we used to go on vacation every winter break, wherever it was, after Christmas, go to Hawaii, whatever. But that's the time of the junior state playdown. So he said to my mom, you can never go on vacation during this time ever again if you want these girls to continue in curling.
My mom's like, oh, but I want to go to Hawaii, but okay.
How did the two of you get hooked up with Nina Roth and Becca Hamilton? How do you find your teammates? Yes. Did you just meet them along the way, or how did that work?
Kind of. So those two are both from McFarland, Wisconsin.
Okay.
And they're, Becca is the sister of Matt Hamilton, who's on Schuster's team.
Okay.
But I played with Becca and juniors after Tab aged out. So we're 2 years apart. So I still had 2 years of juniors, and she was the best Wisconsin team. We were part of the best Minnesota team. So we just kind of hooked up. And then we liked her, and then after juniors, then I played with Nina as well, and yeah, that's kind of how it happened.
And this isn't like beer league softball where you can just be in any shape, because we were talking off air, you have nutritionists and this and that. I mean, what does this all entail? How do you prepare for curling, and how do you stay, you have to be in shape for, how does that all work?
Yeah, we're very fortunate. TCO is a sponsor, and we have our own athletic trainer through the training house down in Egan, which is connected to like the Vikings training center.
You have a trainer?
We do. Cool. Yeah, Mikey, he's fantastic. He kicks our butts all the time. I'm really sore right now because we were there this morning for a 2-hour workout.
And what does that workout entail? Lifting weights
everything.
And such? No
yeah.
kidding.
Oh, yeah. It's a 45-minute warm-up, which involves sprinting and all these things he makes
dynamic
up.
Dynamic stretching. And
like, yep. And then lifting. So we do a lot of upper body for sweeping, a lot of legs, glutes, hamstrings, because that's kind of the, when you're delivering the stone, you're using a lot of leg.
When you're weightlifting, do you do curls?
Yeah.
Bicep curls?
You've been waiting for that one, haven't you? Yep. A lot of bicep curls.
So trainers, nutritionists too?
Yep. So we have a nutritionist, Kayla, also through TCO. She's fantastic. She says, Tara, you need to eat more, and this is what you got to eat. So I do my best to follow what she says. And then we have sports psych as well.
Our sports psychologist?
Mm-hmm. Yep. We love our sports psychologist, Carly.
Well, what is your sports psychologist, think?
Yes, that's what she tells us.
Well, what do they
think more?
I'm sure there's pressure, right? Is that what they're helping you deal with?
Yeah,
definitely. Yeah. Yep. Lots of little things you can kind of practice at home to kind of emulate a competition. But a lot of it is just kind of calming nerves by practicing breathing.
Sure.
Staying focused in the present. What's my job right now? Just lots of little mind tricks that you got to just practice so that they start to become kind of natural.
Do either of you really need that badly? Do you get really worked? I suppose you do. It's competition, especially when you're fighting for the Olympics. You must get the old butterflies in the stomach, and it must be where you break into a sweat too, right?
Yeah, I'm sweating right now talking to you, Common Man.
Well, and that's what I just wanted to let you know. That the two of you should feel very fortunate to be in the studio with me because I don't do many guests.
We are. Yeah.
You have to be special in the studio. Yeah.
Hashtag blessed.
Hashtag blessed because I got to share an hour. I got to give Rosen an hour. And then it's like, I've got a lot to say about a lot of different things.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. Not really. I don't have a lot to say about anything.
It seems like maybe this is from an outside perspective that curling has kind of become a little bit trendier. Is that just from, the Schusters and Americans having success 4 years ago? I've seen places obviously in Blaine, it's, next to Fogarty Arena, curling clubs. How much has the growth and popularity of the sport changed from when you guys first started to where it is now?
Oh, huge.
A lot. Yeah.
Huge. Yeah.
When we first started, St. Paul was your only option in the Twin Cities area. That was the only curling club that was around. And now there's over a handful. There's one in Lakeville, Chaska. There's another one in Frogtown, St. Paul and Blaine and. Yeah, so it's great to see the growth of the sport and all the members wanting to join and join a league. But it kind of does kind of go in cycles is what we're finding. Basically, with every Olympics, with all the television exposure with the Olympic Games, people see it on TV. And then they think, oh, my gosh, do I have a place near me that I could try this sport? And, there's a lot of corporate events that go down at a lot of those clubs during the days. They'll take their workers out and just go for an hour and do a learn to curl thing. So a lot of the clubs offer those. And then hopefully some of those people decide to get involved and join a league and stuff. So yeah, it's growing. It's growing a lot. And it's definitely growing across the country too, not just in the Midwest. Like we were talking, there's clubs in Arizona now and California. So non-traditional, more warm states, but there's curling clubs there now. So it's really, really cool to see.
We have a lot of questions coming in from emailers, booth@kfan.com. I might ask a couple. This one says, what is the weight of the rocks and are they the same for the men and the women?
Good question. Mm-hmm. Yes, they are all 42 pounds. They are made of a special granite that you can only find on an island called Elsa Craig. It's off the coast of Scotland.
Oh, you're making that up.
I am not. That's the truth.
And they're the same. Everyone throws the same. They have smaller stones for juniors, but in our play, the men and women use the same stones.
This emailer says, Tara and Becca are two of the best sweepers in the world. Wish I could sweep like them. That's what someone just emailed.
Thank you.
I second that.
Here's another one. This is from Don. He's a regular listener. He's in Galesburg, North Dakota. He says, please say hi for me. I was piped onto the ice in Hibbing by Doc Skelly.
That's our grandpa.
That's your grandpa.
He says, how cool.
He says, and Don is very proud of the two of you.
Oh, thanks, Don.
What you've been able to accomplish.
Yeah, our grandpa used to play the bagpipes. Mm-hmm. Pretty cool.
While curling her?
Yeah, actually, he would pipe his own teams out and then curl. Because that's kind of the tradition with curling. Is
really?
Always the bagpipes and for the championship day or whatever, they'll bagpipe all the teams out. It's always the same song. And then, what is it? You always have to take a shot with the bagpiper?
Yeah.
You have your own fight song personal or it's the same song for all curlers?
Same song for all curlers.
Oh. Fighters come out with their own song when they enter the ring. I thought maybe you would have your own.
No, but we could come up with one.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Do you know, and I'm not asking you like, you know, I'm not saying, well, you don't have to worry about, you know, like, well, we don't want to sound cocky. Do you expect to win a gold medal? Do you think we're the best in the world and we're going in there and we're going to kick butt and that's just the way it's going to be? Or do you go, well, we're just happy to be there or somewhere in between?
We definitely have a fighting chance based off of kind of the, like, we know all the teams that are going to be at the Olympic Games. We've played all of them a handful of times.
And we've beat all of them
and
before, too.
Okay.
Yeah, and so it's kind of just if we can have a good week and, yeah, like, there's definitely a fighting chance we could be on the podium for sure.
Who's the biggest competition?
I would say Switzerland, but they haven't been playing as well this year. They won the Worlds last year. And then Sweden's always a contender. They won the Olympics 4 years ago.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And Canada always has a good team.
Do you know, and because generally speaking, anytime I watch an Olympic event, they always do talk about favorites. Will you be considered among the favorites then? I would suppose so, right? And do you think you'll be the favorites? You know, like, they'll have a downhill skier or a figure skater. Well, this is the person that most people expect to win the gold medal. Do you think you're thought by most observers and experts and analysts to be the favorite to win?
I don't think we'll be the favorite, but like Tab said, we definitely have a chance to be on the podium. I think our odds will probably be 3 or 4 to 1.
You're making that up.
I want to ask strategy questions. Yes. And then please let me know if this is a really dumb question. Like, is most strategy, like, do every game kind of play out the same way in terms of initial strategy to begin the game? Or, like, does Switzerland play a different strategy than when you go against Sweden? And do you that for, like, pre-scout these teams before you play them?
Yeah, we do watch a lot of these teams compete, and every team does kind of have a go-to and the style of play, whether they like to hit more or if they like to draw more or play more a finesse game with some taps. And so, yes, we kind of know what to expect, I guess, out of each team. But in terms of going and playing against them, it's more just as long as we can play our own game and make more shots than them.
We will.
But then, yeah, also it kind of, to your first part of that question, like the strategy for the first half of the game and the second half of the game, it definitely does depend. It's very dependent on the score. So you tend to play a lot more hits if you're up in the scoreboard, but if you're down by 2, 3, 4 points, you're playing a ton of draws. And so, yes, the strategy just does change from kind of the beginning of the game to the end of the game, depending on the score.
So curling is kind of like, if you're going to compare it to something else, I used to play, is it bocce ball? Is that it, or bocce ball? I used to play that a lot. I mean, is it the same kind of concept a little bit, or am I crazy?
The scoring.
Yeah,
scoring.
Yeah, and similar to the sense that, yeah, you got to get more of your rocks or balls in bocce closer to that center. What's that center called?
The polina.
The polina.
Yes, obviously.
Yeah, that's polina. Exactly right. And did you know that the bocce balls are made from a special granite that you can only find
in Is it called Elsa Craig?
Yeah, and but you can only find it in Madagascar.
Oh,
that's the only place.
Yeah. I always love that
one. You can find it. It's like shuffleboard a little bit, right?
Yeah.
Kind of like what's the one that you do at the bar where you put the sawdust on it and you know what I'm talking about, the little disc?
Yeah.
Is that also shuffleboard?
Yes, but they do have some with like actually curling rocks, mini curling rocks in the curling house at some bars.
Yeah.
Maybe more so in Canada than here, but yeah, you put the sand down.
Do you wear special shoes so you don't slip? Do you wear like are they like
are they like the broomball shoes?
Yeah, are they broomball like?
No.
What are they like? Are they like track shoes where they have little spikes? What are they like?
They're just like a regular tennis shoe, but only one of them, you have a sliding device on it, whether it's Teflon, stainless steel, whatever it is, it's super slippery so that you can, when you're delivering the stone, you can slide out. But then most people cover it up with a gripper to kind of match the grippiness of the other shoe when you're sweeping,
which is like
and
a
walking
rubber.
Around so that you're not going to fall.
Is there like any illegal equipment? You can like, what if you have two slippery things on one on your shoe? Is that against the rules?
No, but it would be hard to walk.
Oh, okay. how do you get, can you get disqualified for improper equipment or anything like that? Or
yeah, actually broom heads.
Yeah. So a few years we've had kind of, they called it Broomgate in our sport where.
No!
Yep.
Dun,
yep.
Dun, dun.
Wait, yeah, hold on. Broomgate.
So, like.
What happened with Broomgate?
It was very controversial, and they did a ton of testing and stuff after the fact to make it more standardized. But basically, the material on your broom that you're sweeping the ice with, that's touching the surface of the ice, was so coarse and
it was basically when you're sweeping it, it was putting tons of scratches in the ice and very much affecting the rock, which way it would curl, or if you could hold it straighter or make it curl more. And so basically there were just all these different types of fabric that were going around that people were using, and there wasn't like a blanket, you know, standard fabric. But after that year, there was just one season of Broomgate that they're like, okay, I guess we need to standardize this because this is getting a little out of hand.
Is it like a whisk broom? Is it the same kind of material, or what is it like, or is it, you know?
No, well, they actually did used to make horsehair brooms.
Oh.
And so those also are now banned. You can't sweep with those because they are too aggressive on the ice.
So what is it? What's the material made of? Some synthetic thing?
I don't even know. It's
some kind of cloth. Yeah.
Is it harmful to the environment? Because I'm a big environmentalist.
Good question.
No, it's not.
I got one more question.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Is there any team that you're going to be facing at the Olympics that you have bad blood with? Like, you do not like that team or country?
No.
We like most of them.
You gotta hate your opponent.
You're right. We hate them all. Yeah. All of them is the answer.
Yeah, there you go. You like to hire me on as like a part-time.
Our intimidation factor.
Yeah. And not a sports psychologist, but someone to get you fired
the exact
up.
Opposite.
Or, hype man.
You know how you see like in football where the team will surround the quarterback like Drew Brees and goes, who that gonna beat them Saints? Oh, I could. Who that gonna beat Team Peterson? I could get you really fired up for it.
The
last question I have for you. Jared Allen, better at sacking the quarterback or as a curler? You know Jared, correct?
Yeah, we've met him.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, he dabbled in our sport, which a lot of people may or may not know. But I don't, maybe you know the story better than me, Tara, but it kind of started with a bet that with his friends. Like, you know, how can I get to the Olympics? Which sport can I go in? And curling is what he came up with.
Well, I think he started with badminton and then went to a badminton tournament and goes, whoa, I can't move that fast or something. So he goes, curling will be my sport.
Well, because he doesn't look like he'd be very good at the pole vault either.
Yeah,
you know?
Fair enough. Yeah. So he does have a pretty good delivery. I think he throws a decent rock, but kind of what his problem was, he thought he could make a team with all football players.
In four years.
And when he had never stepped on the ice before.
He's got no idea. He thought it was easy.
He thought it was easy.
Oh, this is easy to do. Anybody can do this.
Yeah. But he brought great publicity for the sport. So I think
he did a great thing.
But did not make it to the Olympics.
Is
Sorry,
he retired? Did he try again, or did he say once was enough?
I don't know what happened.
I haven't seen him
Maybe
in a while.
Maybe with COVID, too. Yeah. But didn't one of his old teammates start the Nashville Curling Club?
Yeah.
I thought I heard that.
The Nashville Curling Club.
Yeah.
Very good. Peterson sisters, Tabitha and Tara, thank you so much for coming in. I hope you don't mind being the official curling team of the Common Man program.
Perhaps
I just said you're well, good. And a good luck to you in Beijing.
Thanks.
And we'll stay in touch. Maybe we'll have you on a couple of other times. And I don't know if there's a time change there, but maybe after like your first match, you could come on with us. It'd be so much fun.
Applebee's on the line.
And Applebee's is on the line.
Lots of pressure.
Thanks again for coming in, and good luck to the both of you.
Thank you.
We'll take a break. Mark Rosen joins us next here on The Fan.
Rosen joins the Common Man.
Oh, boy.
Next on The Fan.
KFAN, total traffic.
Now from the Holiday Station Stores Traffic Center, here's a check on the roads. Westbound.